Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hopkinton High School. It's Hopkinton Hillers baseball on HCAM. Tom Nappy and Larry Sacklad on the call. Bob Hamilton on camera as the 1-2 Hopkinton Hillers welcome in the 1-3 Holliston Panthers. And we are set for baseball here on HCAM. Stepping in to lead things off is Brad Seymour, the center fielder for the Holliston Panthers, as pitching for the Hillers is Tom Leone, and he will deliver a ball just outside. 1-0 count to start things off. A nice late afternoon for baseball. The usual 3:45 start time. A little bit cloudy out there, but certainly a nice day. 1-1. Temperatures are in the high 60s today. And you can't ask for any better conditions than this. A little bit windy, however. We'll see how that affects this game. 1-2 now. The HCAM Weather Center reading at 73 degrees today. As Leone is set to deliver. That one is in the dirt, 2-2. Leone awaits the sign and deals. That one is fouled away. Count remains 2-2. Take a look at the Hillers field in just a moment as there's strike three for out number one. Now Ben Thomas, the right fielder, will come up to the plate for Holliston. Let's take a look at the Hillers defense. At first base, it is Jake LeBlanc. Over at second base, Dawson McMillan. The shortstop, Chris Burdick. The third baseman is Brendan O'Leary. Behind home plate is Alex Reynolds. We'll go left to right after this pitch. Fouled away, 0-1. From left to right, it is Brett McIntyre, Ben McKenzie, and Zach Sosicki for the Hillers.
Tommy is a fastball pitcher primarily, but looks like over the winter time he's worked on his breaking ball, which is good to see. He can get away with it at junior varsity, throwing just fastballs, but up at varsity you need a little wrinkle. Looks like he's worked on that.
Gets the sign he likes and is set to deal. There's a strike. 0-1. Well, Holliston, a young team, they've struggled a bit to start off the season, but they only have six seniors on the roster, a whole lot of juniors and sophomores, but the program certainly on the uprise. That one up high under head coach Joe Santos.
Holliston is hitting .260 as a team so far in this young season.
That one is upstairs. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike. There is out number two, two strikeouts to start off the day for Leone. Now stepping in is Zach Jacobs, the catcher. Wind up and the pitch. This is up the middle on the ground, gloved by the second baseman, throw to first, and that will do it for the top half of the first inning as Holliston goes down 1-2-3 to the bottom of the first we go. The Hillers coming up next on HCAM. Bottom of the first inning, the Hopkinton Hillers coming up. Let's take a look at their batting order. Leading things off is the center fielder, Ben McKenzie. Second baseman, Dawson McMillan, batting second. The catcher, Alex Reynolds, batting third. Jake LeBlanc, the first baseman in the cleanup role. Chris Burdick, the shortstop, batting fifth. Tony Farina is the designated hitter, batting sixth. Brett McIntyre, the left fielder, batting seventh. Zach Sesitsky, the right fielder, batting eighth. Dylan O'Leary, the third baseman, batting ninth. On the mound for the Holliston Panthers, it is Ben Dooley. He is a senior, and he is set to work to his first hitter of the day. First pitch upstairs to Ben McKenzie. Let's take a look at the Holliston field. It's Ben Dooley on the mound for the Panthers as he is set to deliver another pitch. And there is a strike. Over at first base is Jake Obid. The second baseman is Jack Larsh. The shortstop, Jake Poor. The third baseman, Lewis Rossi, as that one is inside. Catcher Zach Jacobs from left to right, Sam Athey, Brad Seymour, and Ben Thomas. Lineup and the pitch. That one is upstairs, 3-1 now to Ben McKenzie. Set to deliver. There's a strike. Full count now. That one is in the dirt, and McKenzie draws the leadoff walk.
Ben is the only five-tool player on this Hillers varsity team. If he sees a chance to run, or he reads the ball in the dirt, he's going to be off to the races.
Stepping in now is Dawson McMillan, the second baseman. As Dooley will work from the stretch, McKenzie leading off and checking at first. He slides back safely.
Ben just timing up that pickoff move by the pitcher. I don't know whether that was his best move or not. We'll see what kind of a lead he gets, as he was in safely.
McKenzie with four stolen bases already on this young season, as that one's up high. Dooley awaits the sign. Runner leading off of first, he delivers. Checking at first from the catcher, and he slides back just safe. Good throw down the line. Runner leading off of first, Dooley from the stretch. Checking at first, runner back safe. Hillers won their first game of the season at Hopkinton High School. So they took down Millis 7-2. Game that we had for you right here on HCAM, as there's a strike. McMillan steps back in the box and awaits the pitch.
Dawson likes to go and hit to the left side. There's a huge hole between short and third.
Checking once again at first. I'm sure Dooley knows how much of a threat Ben McKenzie is to take off from that first base bag. Checking once again, and almost got him that time.
Dooley's got to concentrate on the hitter and not let McKenzie shake him up.
Certainly tell McKenzie playing a little bit of a mind games with Dooley right now. There's a strike. That'll fill up the count on McMillan. 2-2, excuse me. From the stretch, runner leading off of first, the 2-2 pitch. This is hit in the air to right field. It is going to land foul. Just a little bit too far to the right side there.
Dawson looks like he's put on 20 pounds from last year.
Hiller is hitting 312 as a team so far this season. Checking at first, and McKenzie is back just safe. McKenzie's certainly not afraid to challenge Dooley here. That is a breaking pitch, which lands just a little bit too far inside. That'll fill up the count.
If McKenzie's going to go, he's going to watch that front foot of that pitcher.
Runner taking off from first, and there will be no throw, but it will not matter as Dawson McMillan draws the walk.
By watching the front foot of that pitcher, it means you're clear to go. He cannot go over to first base.
That's two straight walks for Dooley. Stepping in now, Alex Reynolds, the catcher. Off to a nice start on the young season. Both runners leading now. There's a strike. That would not count out the double steal attempt here.
There is speed on the base pass. There's no question about it.
Reynolds steps back in, off to a 5.56 batting average so far this season. 5 for 9 at the plate. That one's low. Good defensive play by the catcher. Both runners leading. Dooley gives a long look at second base and deals. That one's in the dirt, and Jacobs tried to keep it in front of him but could not, and both runners will advance on the wild pitch.
That's reading the down angle. Both those boys, McKenzie and McMillan, read that ball in the dirt and took off right away. They didn't even think about it.
I think base running is going to be a big weapon this season for the Hillers. They know they're going to have to manufacture a good amount of runs. Line up and the pitch. The breaking pitch is fouled away. A 1-2 count.
Alex can turn on any pitch.
As this one is hit up the left side, that'll drop into left field. One run is in, a second run being waved around, and it's going to be 2-0 Hillers, a 2-RBI single for Alex Reynolds.
And his batting average continues to rise.
Yeah, well above that 500 mark now. And that would make him 6-for-10, so 600 average now for Reynolds. It's pretty impressive, to say the least. As Jake LeBlanc will step in, and he's off to a nice start as well, 3-for-10 at the plate. He's driven in 3 runs and scored 1. Reynolds leading off of first. That one just outside.
Alex getting a good secondary lead off first base. He doesn't have the most speed, but you don't have to have speed to steal bases.
Line up and the pitch. That one's going to grab the inside corner for strike 1, 1-1. A lot of these Holliston Panthers and Hopkinton Hillers players familiar with each other. A lot of them play Ashland Legion baseball together. So that one's in the dirt, 2-1. First baseman Jake Obid, one of the members for the past couple seasons on Ashland Legion Baseball. We'll certainly excited to bring you another season of Ashland Legion Baseball once the summer hits, as there's strike 2 on the swinging strike there.
Again, Holliston giving the third base line wide open.
From the stretch, and it looked like almost a check swing there, but he made contact over the second baseman. It goes, throw to first, and they will get the out, but Reynolds does advance to second. 4-3 for LeBlanc, two away. Then he'll bring up Chris Burdick. Excuse me, that's the first out of the inning, as the shortstop will step in. Well, pretty good piece of hitting there to move the runner into scoring position. As Dooley working from the stretch. There's a strike, 0-1 to Burdick. Chris Burdick off to a nice start at the plate. 2-for-3 overall. 7 plate appearances, however. Has also drawn a walk and was hit by a pitch twice already this season. And he will make contact here into right center, ranging over. Unable to make the catch is the center fielder. Looked like it went off of his glove, and everybody's going to be safe. It'll be runners on the corners now for the Hillers. Reynolds up to third, Burdick safely aboard over at first base, and now Tony Farina, the designated hitter, will come up to the plate. Well, that was a tough play to make as both fielders came ranging over. And it went off the glove of the center fielder, Brad Seymour.
I'd like to see whether Coach Simos has a play on with first and third. Anthony Farina, power hitter.
Both runners leading as Dooley set to deliver. Checking at first, runner slides back safe. From the stretch. That one upstairs, 1-1. Well, a nice start to this one for the Hills. Already 2 runs in, only 1 out. Runners on the corners. And there's another pitch upstairs, 2-1. Now the head coach, Joe Santos, is going to come out and talk to his pitcher, Ben Dooley, who's struggling out there.
I think what he's going to talk to him about is his release point. If you can't find your release point, the ball will go all over the place.
And at first it was the Hillers drawing a couple walks, and then the 2 RBI single by Alex Reynolds to drive in Ben McKenzie and Dawson McMillan. And Jake LeBlanc grounded out, but it pushed Reynolds up to second. And then Burdick pushed Reynolds up to third with the single. Pretty good rally to start things off for the Hillers in their second game of the season at Hopkinton High School.
Senior Brett McKenzie. I should say freshman Ben McKenzie started off with a walk.
Farina waits the pitch. That one is outside.
Brett McIntyre is waiting on deck, the senior.
3-1 pitch in the dirt. And that is going to load him up for the Hillers. Farina up to first, Burdick up to second. Reynolds stays put at
second,
third, and
it
looks like we're going to have a pitching change here. So an early pitching change for the Holliston Panthers. That's going to do it for Ben Dooley. And it'll be Kip Stopa coming into the game for the Panthers to take over on the mound. And while he gets ready, we'll take a timeout here in the bottom of the first. The Hopkinton Hillers will continue at the plate, already leading the Holliston Panthers 2-0 on HCAM. Welcome back to the bottom of the first inning as Brett McIntyre will step in to face the second pitcher of the day for the Holliston Panthers, Kip Stopa. As their starter, Ben Dooley, struggled. Faced 6 batters, managed to get 1 out. Hillers scored 2 runs. We'll recap in just a moment as that one's outside. 1-0. Larry, during the break, you noticed that they sent Tom Leone back down to the bullpen area to throw a few pitches as it's been a long extended bottom of the half of the first. Leg yeah. lift and the pitch fouled away.
Brett, a singles hitter. Good contact, good eye. And an excellent suicide squeeze bunter.
That certainly could be a possibility here. Wind up and the pitch. That one just outside, tracked down by the catcher. Who's been pretty busy behind the plate so far today. Zach Jacobs. Scopa from the stretch. Swinging strike there. That'll make the count 2-2. Let's recap what happened so far in this bottom of the first. Ben McKenzie started off with a walk. Dawson McMillan then walked. Alex Reynolds drove them both in with a 2-RBI single. Jake LeBlanc grounded out, but it pushed Reynolds up to second. Chris Burdick hit a single, which pushed Reynolds up to third. As this one gets by the catcher, a high pitch, and one run is in for the Hillers. Everybody pushing up. Alex Reynolds scores on the wild pitch. Chris Burdick up to third, and Tony Farina up to second. It's 3-0 Hopkinton.
All Brett needs to do is put the ball in play, and that'll play another run.
Chris Burdick reached due to a single. Farina with the walk. Now McIntyre with a chance here, and that is going to get by the catcher. He will take off for first base and be successfully aboard. And Jacobs has been busy behind the plate for sure. Base is now loaded for the Hillers. Zach Sisitsky will step in.
Zach has a beautiful inside-out swing. Not your typical lefty uppercut swing.
Wind up and the pitch. On the ground, left side, slow roller. Gloved in the grass, throw to first. They get one, but a run is in, and it's 4-0 Hillers as Burdick comes around. So the sacrifice ground out there by Sisitsky. That was a good piece of hitting. Burdick comes around, two men on still, and now Dylan O'Leary to the plate, a swinging strike there.
Contrast their hitting styles. Dylan O'Leary is a more prototypical left-handed hitter with an uppercut compared to Zach Sisitsky.
Hillers have batted around here on the bottom of the first. There's a swinging strike. 0-2. Leg lift and the pitch. That one down low. 1-2 count. Both runners leading, and this is hit in the air to right field. That's going to get down and land in for a base hit. One run is in, a second run being waved around. It is 6-0 Hillers, a 2-RBI single from Dylan O'Leary.
You notice the speed of Brett McIntyre with two outs going all the way on that base hit.
Tony Farina and Brett McIntyre both score. Now Ben McKenzie will come up for a second time in this bottom half of the first inning. Pitcher steps off, takes a look at first, runner back safely. Quite a rally to start things off for the Hillers. This is hit in the air, a high fly ball to the right side. It is ranging over to foul territory, and it'll drop foul.
Tom, are those runs charged to Dooley?
Dooley has been responsible for 5 of the 6 runs. Brett McIntyre was the only run that Kip Stoppa has been responsible for. Runner
sir.
Leading off of first. Leg lift and the pitch. There's a strike, and he's going to take off over to second, and the throw is going to be off the mark. It is a stolen bag for Dylan O'Leary.
McKenzie can hit the ball to all fields. And he's got a duck out on second base, waiting to be driven in.
Runner leading off of second, the windup and the pitch, it's upstairs. Set to deliver. That one's in the dirt. Jacobs has to block it, and the runner's going to take off from second, throw to third, not in time. And O'Leary up to third on the wild pitch.
I am really impressed with Coach Simos's base running instruction. That ball was red in the dirt all the way. And Dylan O'Leary is not the fastest guy on the team.
Alston with their second pitcher of the game in there, as the Hillers have rallied in this bottom of the first. That one's fouled away. Let's take a look at the line on the Holliston starter, Ben Dooley. He pitched a third of an inning, giving up five runs, one hit, three walks, and had two wild pitches. And Kip Stoppa, the new pitcher, responsible for one of the six runs that have scored. As this is hit in the air, it's a deep right field, but in a good position to make the catches, Ben Thomas. And after a long bottom of the first and six Hillers runs, we will head over to the top half of the second. Hopkinton leading Holliston 6-0 on HCAM. Top half of the second inning, the Hillers off to a 6-0 lead as Tom Leone will come out for his second inning of work. Larry, he's been on the bench really for a good at least a half hour or so during that bottom of the first. So we'll have to see how the extended half inning affected him, as Jake Obid, the first baseman, steps in, and he will put this one into right field, as that'll get down for a base hit. A leadoff single for the first baseman.
Well, Coach Simos thinks of everything, so he's already got somebody warming up despite a six-run lead.
And that'll bring up the DH, Zach Peston. Jack Larsh, second baseman, due up on deck.
That last inning by Holliston can't help their team ERA, which was 6.79 at the beginning of this game.
Yeah, pitching has certainly been a big concern for Holliston, as that one is hit in the air, and it is in playable territory. High fly ball ranging over to make the catch. This is the third baseman, Dylan O'Leary. And that was good communication in the infield there by the Hillers. One away, Jack Larsh coming up. Obid still over at first.
Dylan O'Leary had to come a long way for that ball. And Alex Reynolds sort of went a little bit out of where his territory is as the ball was spinning away from him. So the other option would have been Tommy Leone, and pitchers tend to shy away from pop-ups.
On the ground, right side, gloved by the second baseman, throw to first, and they will get the out. Obid pushes up to second. 4-3 ground out for Larsh. And now Lewis Rossi, the third baseman, will step in. Leone from the stretch takes a look at second. A little bit leading off the bag. That one's fouled away. Off of second, Leone gives him a long look and deals. And this is hit up the right side and foul. 0-2. Hillers scored six runs in the bottom of the first, and they did it on three hits. Hillers had four hitters walk. They are hoping to get out of this top half of the second with no damage done, as there is two outs, as that pitch down low. Good job by Reynolds keeping it in front of him. A little bit back to the second base bag.
Anything that's on or near the plate, Alex Reynolds will get.
Leone from the stretch, takes a long look in. Leg lift and the pitch, swinging strike, and he will get Rossi. He's gonna take a run to first base, but it will not matter, they will call him out. And that'll do it for the top half of the second. To the bottom of the second we go. Hiller is leading Holliston 6-0 on HCAM. Bottom of the second inning, the Hillers coming back up to the plate with a 6-0 lead. Tom Nappe, Larry Sacklad on the call for Hopkinton Hillers baseball. Bob Hamilton on camera. Coming up to lead off the inning for the Hillers is Dawson McMillan. He walked and scored a run in the first inning. It's a 2-3-4 hitters. Dawson McMillan, Alex Reynolds, Jake LeBlanc. As the lefty second baseman will step in. Out there for his second inning of work is Kip Stoppa. Came in relief of Ben Dooley in the first inning after Dooley struggled. Stoppa set to deliver and it is outside.
Tommy Leone got the last Holliston hitter on his one and only curveball of the day, and it was a beauty.
Leg lift and the pitch. That one is going to sit McMillan down, 2-0. He deals, swinging strike there, 2-1.
Dawson likes to hit the ball to the left side, giving him an advantage as a left-handed hitter, as he'll be two steps out of the box before the fielders have a chance to do anything.
McMillan was 4-for-8 at the plate coming into this game. There's a strike. He has scored a run and driven in two. .600 on base percentage as he's also drawn a couple walks. That one upstairs, that'll fill up the count. Wind up and the pitch inside and he draws the walk. His second walk of the day.
Dawson always a threat to steal. I think Coach Simos likes to see what the runner can get away with in terms of a lead and take one look at a pickoff move.
Alex Reynolds stepping in now. He had a 2-RBI single in the first inning to get the rally started. He takes the outside pitch there. Drove in McKenzie and McMillan. Runner leading off of first. Stoppa set to deal, that one's outside, it'll get away, and McMillan advancing to second on the wild pitch. And now he's gonna go to third, the throw to third is in time. So they throw McMillan out, trying to head to third, and that was certainly a little bit too much of an effort there, I think. I think you take the base and call it a day, especially with the catcher right near the ball at that point. Right up and the pitch, and it'll turn Reynolds away.
A little chin music from the Holliston pitcher right there.
Stoppa deals in the dirt. That'll make it 3-1 on Reynolds.
Interesting how their infield is aligned. The third baseman is way off the line. And you've got the power hitting part of the lineup, be more than likely to pull the ball.
Lineup and the pitch. And there's the walk. Second walk of the inning for Stoppa. Jake LeBlanc will come up to the plate.
The Hillers haven't had a home run this year, I don't think. This young man is capable of hitting one.
That one down low, 1-0. Stop by having trouble finding the plate as of right now. There is warm-up action for Holliston. That one inside. 2-0.
Anything in the dirt and Reynolds will be off.
Leg lift and the pitch, and this is hit in the air to the left side. This is a deep high fly ball, and it is going to drop foul. Close to the fence out there.
Little early on that one.
Yeah. And the wind just took that enough to put it foul. Oh, you mentioned the Hillers not having a home run yet. That was probably the closest they've come so far, at least on their home field. Runner leading off of first. 2-1 pitch is in there for a strike.
Reynolds, McKenzie, LeBlanc.
Swing strike there, and LeBlanc goes down swinging, one away.
And Farina are the threats to go yard here.
Chris Burdick steps in. He hit a single in the first inning, scored a run. That was the fourth Hillers run of the inning, scored by Chris Burdick. That was off a sacrifice RBI by Sasitsky as there's a strike.
Reynolds would do anything to get himself in scoring position.
Wind up and the pitch. Strike two. Stoppa starting to find the plate a little bit better. That one in the dirt.
Good read by Alex Reynolds.
Stretch, leg lift and the pitch, swinging strike, and that is going to be the third and final out there. Holliston Panthers will come up to the plate. You're watching Hillers Baseball on HCAM. Top half of the third inning, 6-0 lead for the Hillers. 8-9-1 due up for Holliston. Jake Poore, Sam Athey, and Brad Seymour. All spring season long, you can catch Hopkinton Hillers baseball and softball coverage right here on HCAM. The next game after this will be Hillers softball against Bellingham. That's of course unless some weather interferes with that. There is potential for rain later this week as first pitch to Poore is outside. That one upstairs. Tom Leone out there for his third inning of work. So far has given up no runs and a hit. Has three strikeouts on the afternoon.
Coach Simos has got the bullpen working again. He's always one step ahead.
Yeah, and he seems to not be afraid to have the bullpen work good amount of innings just to have them there in case.
He's blessed with an abundance of pitching talent.
One is just outside. 3-1 count. He likes the sign and deals. And this is hit into center field. That'll drop in for a base hit. A single for Poor to start things off in the third. Sam Athey will step in. Left fielder, multi-sport athlete for Holliston. Very good football player as well. Expected to be a key part, or was a key part of the Holliston football team over the last couple of seasons, in his senior year now. There's a strike. There's Mitch Karp warming up for the Hillers, it looks like. Leone takes a look at first, runner slides back.
Tommy will use the step off rather than the pure pick.
Line up and the pitch on the ground, foul. Up the right side, 0-2.
And he'll adjust his times to the plate so the runner will not be able to get a bead on him.
Checking at first, runner back, and the ball gets away from the first baseman, but he'll track it down before Poor could think about advancing. From the stretch. Leg lift and the pitch. And this is hit in the air, foul.
That was a nice breaking pitch by Tommy. Should mix in a few more of those. They definitely have the Holliston hitters off balance.
Takes a look at first and now is set to deliver. Shakes off the first sign and now deals, and this one is hit in the air foul to the right side. Runner leading off of first. Leone set to deal. Breaking pitch, and this is hit up the third baseline. It'll get past the dive of Dylan O'Leary into left field. Everybody's safe, a single for Athey. Poor up to second. Now Brad Seymour, another multi-sport athlete for Holliston, will come up to the plate. Also a member of the football team.
That ball hit the bag, Tom, right?
Yep, went off the third base bag and hopped over the glove of Dylan O'Leary. Pretty good piece of hitting there, and Holliston's got something going here in the third inning. Line up and the pitch, the bunt pulled back. It is a strike, throw to first, and it gets by LeBlanc, but everyone's going to stay put as he quickly tracks it down.
I think Alex Reynolds has the green light. If he sees space between first base and the runner, he will go down to back pick.
Coach Simo's out to talk to Leone. I wonder what the leash will be with him, as he hasn't really given up a whole lot of hits, but it's been an extended outing due to that long bottom of the first inning. Right now you get a pretty comfortable lead, so if Holliston starts plating some runs, maybe the leash won't be as long as it normally would be. Seymour steps back in. He struck out his first time up in the first inning. Line up in the pitch, pulls the bunt back, and there's a ball, 1-1.
Being down 6 runs and attempting a sacrifice doesn't seem like that's the best way to put some runs across the plate.
Yeah, I figured you would just give your hitter the green light to swing away here. And he will bunt it foul, 1-2. Seymour does have speed, though, so they could be hoping that he's able to beat out the bunt. But I think Carlson is just trying to get on the scoreboard right now. Both runners leading. Lineup and the pitch. Breaking pitch is down low as the umpire signaled to the infield ump if Seymour went or not. Two and two now.
Dawson McMillan trying to keep the runner close at second base. Tommy Leone may not even attempt to go there, but just to keep him close enough.
Lineup and the pitch. Up the middle it goes, and glove by the shortstop. Throw to first, not in time. Everybody's safe. The bases are loaded for Holliston. Pour up to third, Athey up to second. Seymour aboard at first base. Ben Thomas, the right fielder, to the plate. Nope, we're going to have a pinch hitter here. Tim Ringy is going to come in and hit for Ben Thomas.
Coach Simoes wants the out. He is not bringing the infield in. He wants two or one, at the very least.
Bases loaded, no outs. That one upstairs, 1-0. From the stretch is Leone. Up high. Line up and the pitch. There's a strike. Two and one. Set to deliver, as this is hit in the air, shallow fly ball over towards the second base bag. The shortstop ranges over and makes the catch. That's a big out there as no runner is able to push up.
Is that an infield fly, Tom?
I'm not sure if the rule applied there. I think it might have been just far enough where he had to make that catch. One away, Zach Jacobs in the batter's box, takes a strike. One out, bases loaded. Set to deliver up high.
Tommy probably throws in the low 80s now.
One pitch. Third base side, glove by the third baseman. He'll step on the bag for one, throw to first. And they're gonna call him out, he got him. A 5-3 double play, and despite Holliston having the bases loaded with no outs, the Hillers get out of it unscathed. It's 6-0 Hopkinton heading to the bottom of the third. Bottom half of the third inning, a 6-0 lead for the Hopkinton Hillers over the Holliston Panthers. Due up for Hopkinton is the 6-7 and 8 hitters, the DH Tony Farina, Brett McIntyre the left fielder, and Zach Sosicki the right fielder. Tim Ringy does stay in the game for the Holliston Panthers, takes over for Ben Thomas in right field. Some good defensive work by the Hillers in the top half of the third. Holliston loaded up the bases with three straight singles to start off the third inning. And then Tim Ringy flew out to the shortstop, and then Zach Jacobs hit into a 5-3 double play as that one's upstairs. Two for Rena, 1-0.
What made that double play so impressive is LeBlanc's footwork and is able to dig the ball on a short hop.
And that one is hit in the air, foul territory, and that'll make the count 0-1 as that one's out of play. It was a great throw by Dylan O'Leary as well to get that double play. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike.
We were talking about power hitters before. Anthony Farina is certainly one of them.
1-1, and he reached out for that one. Could not make contact. That's a strikeout. Well, Kip Stopa came into the game in the first inning to relieve Ben Dooley and struggled a bit in that remainder of the first inning, but it has since struck out three hitters. Pretty good outing it's turning into for Kip Stopa. There's a strike to McIntyre.
Brett is one of the many players that played on the 2012 Hopkinton Little League District 11 champions in the Williamsport tournament.
On the ground, up the middle, glove by the shortstop, throw to first, and they got him. 6-3 goes McIntyre, two away. Zach Sosicki will step in. Lefty steps in and awaits the pitch, and it's outside.
Zach can hit to all fields.
Set to deliver. Up the middle, takes a couple hops on the infield grass, gloved by the second baseman, throw to first, and they got him, no problem. 1-2-3 go the Hillers, to the top of the fourth we go. It's 6-0 Hopkinton. Hillers baseball on HCAM. Tom Nappy, Larry Sacklett on the call. Bob Hamilton on camera. Top half of the fourth inning as the Holliston Panthers will come back up to the plate, trailing 6-0 to the Hopkinton Hillers. 4-5 and 6 due up for Holliston. Jake Obid, Zach Presson, and Jack Larsh. Obid hit a single his last time up in the first inning. Starter Tom Leone out there for his fourth inning of work. First pitch is low in the dirt, 1-0. Line up and the pitch. Down low. Leone is set to deal. There's a strike. The 2-1 pitch. Up the third base side, and it is foul.
Dylan was going to make sure that was foul, if he even had to kick the ball.
2-2. It's the side he likes and deals as this is hit in the air, a high fly ball to right field, and that is going to land way out, and oh, it's gonna be caught. What a great catch out there. Really had a range over, and that is one advantage of not having a fence out there in that right field area, because if they had that fence out there, that looked like it would have cleared it, Larry.
The ball goes up in the air with Ben McKenzie anywhere near it, he's gonna go get it.
That was very impressive by McKenzie. I thought it was going to land just in front of him, but he's able to get there. One away. There's a strike.
Same thing for the left fielder, Brett McIntyre. He's been known to take 100 fly balls on his front lawn every day.
And this is hit in the air, foul territory, right side, and out of play. To the track it goes, 0-2.
McKenzie covered a lot of ground out there.
At last check, the Hillers softball team leading Holliston through three innings. 5-0 as that one's fouled away. 0-2 on the DH. Zach Pessin, a junior.
I believe he has a brother on the team, a sophomore.
Leone delivers down low, 1-2. Got by Reynolds.
Looks like Ryan Wolf is warming up in the bullpen.
Leone deals. This is hit in the air to left center, ranging over, coming to a dive, and he is going to make the catch for the second out. What a job out in left field by Brett McIntyre.
That's what 100 fly balls a day will do for you. Rarely misses a ball if it goes in the air, rarely.
Some impressive outfield work so far this inning by the Hillers. Nice. 1-0 to Larsh, the second baseman. Leone deals, 2-0. Hopkinton certainly very impressive defensively today. A lot of great plays out there made in the field. 3-0 now to Larsh. And he will draw the four pitch walk. Louis Rossi, the third baseman, stepping in now. Leading off of first, lineup and the pitch upstairs.
I think Holliston has 19 steals through five games.
From the stretch, and that one up high. Warm-up action continues for the Hillers. We only having a little bit of trouble finding the plate right now. Six straight balls from Leone. There's a strike. Runner leading off of first. Wind up and the pitch. Strike two. Runner taking off from first as this one is hit in the air foul. We'll have to head back to first base.
He had that base stolen. Well, the only lefties on the team are Sosinski, Gaughan, and Ryan Wolf. By process of elimination, it has to be Ryan Wolf down in the bullpen.
Hey, Lou. Hey, Lou. Hey, takes off the first sign now. Deals down low. Nice job by Reynolds. Locking that one up. A little bit wild on that pitch. It's a full count now.
They're not holding the runner on.
Leone deals. That one just high. Reynolds did not like that call. Jake Poore will step in. That was pretty close to the strike zone, in my opinion. Could have went either way.
A little curious why there was nobody holding that runner on.
I'm going to talk things over with Leone.
Matt Anderson, very familiar with Tommy Leone. He trains at his academy during the winter, as does many of these Hopkinton players. Probably see something in Tommy's delivery. Wants to straighten it out.
From the stretch, two on, two outs. Upstairs, that's going to get by Reynolds, and everyone's going to push up. Larsh up to third, Rossi to second. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. From the stretch. Check swing couldn't hold. One and two. Can Leone get out of another jam? Got out of a no out bases loaded jam in the third. Now two on, two outs. Breaking pitch hit into left field, and that'll drop down. One Hollison run is in. A second run being waved around as it continues to roll out in left field. Got past Brett McIntyre. Two runs are in for the Hollison Panthers. And that is going to be a two RBI base hit for Jake Poore, who is now standing over at second base. And that might be it for Leone. Let's see what Coach Simos does here. And he will indeed take the ball. We'll have a relief pitcher for the Hillers. A pretty good outing for Leone, but cannot get out of the jam. Ryan Wolf will come in and take over pitching duties for Hopkinton. We're going to take a timeout. It's Hillers baseball on HCAM. Continuing on with the fourth inning, top half of the fourth. New pitcher for the Hopkinton Hillers, it is Ryan Wolf. As the lefty is set to deal to Sam Athey. That one is a ball just outside, 1-0. Two runs in for the Panthers, one still on base. It was Jake Poore with the two RBI double. He's over at second. Drove in Jack Larsh and Lewis Rossi. It's a 6-2 ball game now as that one's fouled into the backstop. 1-1. Wolf working from the stretch, trying to get out of this jam. Swing strike, 1-2, it gets by Reynolds, and runner from second will push up. Jake Poore up to third. Tom Leone still responsible for the runner on base, but his line so far is 3 2/3 of an inning. 5 hits, 2 runs, both of them earned, 2 walks, and 3 strikeouts.
Ryan Wolf, very deceptive left-hander, throws a lot of arms and legs at you.
as this is hit in the air to left field, deep left field, but ranging over to make the catch is Brett McIntyre for the third and final out of the top half of the fourth. To the bottom of the fourth we go. It's 6-2 Hopkinton. Bottom half of the fourth inning, as the Hillers will come back up to the plate. It's now a 6-2 lead for Hopkinton. And we have a pinch hitter coming up, Steven Simos, hitting for Dylan O'Leary. 9-1-2 due up for the Hillers. Pitch to Simos is a ball, 1-0. It's Kip Stoppa out there for another inning of work. So far as pitch 2 2/3 of an inning in this game. That one upstairs, 2-0.
Stevie, an excellent hitter. He could hit the ball to all fields. Doesn't hurt that his father played 4 years at Boston College and regularly teaches hitting to both boys and girls.
That one is outside, 3-0. See what the leash is here with Stoppa. He's thrown a good amount of pitches in this game. There's a strike, 3-1. Wind up and the pitch. Down low, and Simos draws the walk. And McKenzie stepping in for the Hillers, the center fielder. 0-for-1 so far today, walked and scored a run in the first. Runner leading off of first base. Wind up and the pitch. Up the middle it goes, on the grass, throw to second for one, and that's all they'll get. So they get the force out. McKenzie aboard on the 6-4 force out, and that'll bring up Dawson McMillan. Dawson has walked twice in this game, scored a run in the first.
I don't think the Holliston pitcher has picked over yet.
McKenzie leading off of first. That one is outside. 1-0. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. Stoppa deals. That one low, 2-1.
You would think Ben McKenzie would try and bait the pitcher to throw over to see what kind of a move he had.
Set to deliver, runner taking off from first. Pitch was up high. The throw to second is high, but a great job by the second baseman pulling that one down, saving it from going into center field. Jack Larsh really had to get the ups on that one. It is a stolen base, however, for McKenzie.
Had the throw been close, he still would have had it beat.
Wind up and the pitch. This is hit in the air to center field, and ranging over, making the catch for the out is Brad Seymour. McKenzie will stay put at second.
The Holliston pitcher was on the ball by backing up third base. Had McKenzie been thinking about tagging up?
Alex Reynolds steps in. He has singled and walked in this game. 2 RBI single in the first, score the Hillers' first 2 runs of the game. That one outside.
Alex has to be looking down the third base line.
stretches. Stoppa. Kenzie leading off of second. This is hit in the air, foul. 1-1. Line up and the pitch. Breaking pitch got him swinging there. 1-2. Stop a set the deal. That one outside.
It's a good take by Alex.
Two pitch. There's strike three, got him looking. And that will do it for the bottom of the fourth. To the top of the fifth we go. Hopkinton leading Holliston 6-2 on HCAN. Top half of the fifth inning. Out there for another inning of work for the Hillers on the mound is Ryan Wolf. And he will deal with the 1, 2, and 3 hitters as Brad Seymour takes ball one. Brad Seymour up first, Tim Ringy due up second, and Zach Jacobs. Wolf deals. That one just outside, 2-0. Hillers softball defeated Holliston 9-1. Was the final score in that game. Hillers softball now off to a 5-1 start. Up the third base side, glove by the third baseman, throw to first, no problem. As Dylan O'Leary goes across to LeBlanc for the 5-3, one away. Tim Ringy will step in, the right fielder.
Brian, primarily a fastball pitcher, but does possess an excellent changeup.
Line up and the pitch, upstairs. Set to deliver. There's a strike, 1-1.
Alex getting to call his own game here versus the Hopkinton coach relaying signals to his catcher. That's how much confidence Coach Simos has in Alex Reynolds.
1-2 now. Line up and the pitch. And he is going to make contact. Slow roller on the infield grass. Wolf throws over to first and got him. 1-3 goes Ringy, 2 away.
I've been following Ryan Wolf since T-ball, and that's the first breaking pitch I've ever seen from him.
As Zach Jacobs steps in. Line up and the pitch. Down low.
Ryan can use that breaking pitch as another weapon.
Leg lift and the pitch. That one upstairs. 2-0. Wolf gets the sign he likes and deals. And this is going to get through the gap between short and third. Into left field it goes. It is a single for Jacobs. Two out single. Now the cleanup hitter, Jake Obid, will step in.
The Holliston base runner better watch out with Ryan Wolf's pickoff move.
Runner leading off of first, that pitch upstairs.
It's always tough for the base runner with a lefty, But a lefty with a really good move is doubly tough.
1-0 pitch, checking at first, runner slides back.
He didn't show him his best move there. It's another way of playing cat and mouse.
Checking at first, runner was caught off the bag. Now to second, caught in the pickle. Back to first it goes. And now chasing him down is Wolf, and he got him. Good job by Wolf. Showing off his speed there to tag Zach Jacobs for the third and final out of the top of the fifth. To the bottom of the fifth we go. Hopkinton leading Holliston 6-2. Bottom of the fifth inning. 4, 5, and 6 due up for the Hillers. Jake LeBlanc, Chris Burdick, and Tony Farina. As LeBlanc will step in, he's 0-2 so far today. Kip Stoppa still on the mound for Holliston. And he's had a nice outing since coming in relief for Ben Dooley as that pitch is upstairs, 1-0. Dooley was responsible for 5 of the 6 Hillers runs. All 6 runs for the Hillers scored in the first inning. Holliston scored their 2 in the fourth. Lined up and the pitch. Hit in the air to right center. Both fielders ranging over, and it'll get past the attempted dive of the right fielder, Ben Thomas, and it is a stand-up single for LeBlanc.
That was a good piece of hitting by Jake. Went the other way with it.
Excuse me, that's Tim Ringy out there in right field now. We're gonna have a pinch runner. In for LeBlanc, it'll be Connor Hebert, the junior. Bringing in the speed. Now Chris Burdick will step in for the Hillers.
Does Connor have his football helmet on?
Right?
Nope.
Be the feature back for the Hillers football team next season. Sun's starting to peek through a little bit more here in the bottom of the fifth. Kip from the stretch, runner leading off of first. There's a strike.
I'm still waiting for the Holliston pitcher to pick over to see what kind of move he's got with Connor on first base. He's probably got the green light.
Runner taking off from first, and that one got by Jacobs. And actually, did they call that a hit by a pitch? Nope, they're going to bring him back. But it is. And they're also going to send Hebert back to first. So the count is going to, I believe, be 1-1. They might have.
Was called, time called?
Yeah, it might have been time called, or did he get a piece of it with his bat? It's a strike. It looks like they're gonna call it a foul ball. I thought it might have nicked his bat a little bit.
I thought it got the home plate umpire square. We'll have to find out in between innings.
Bunt down the first baseline is foul. One and two count on Burdick. Hebert leading off of first in the pinch run for LeBlanc. Nice breaking pitch there, got Burdick looking. Tony Farina, the DH, will step in. 0-for-1, walked in the first inning and scored a run.
I think what they want to get Connor in scoring position for Anthony Farina.
Runner taking off from first on the ground up the first base side. It is gloved by the first baseman Obid, and he will take it to the bag for the unassisted ground out.
Connor was off on the pitch.
Yeah, Hebert pushed up to second, 2 outs. And now Brett McIntyre, the left fielder, will step in. Kip Stoppa showing some good stuff out there on the mound. Good array of pitches as well. Certainly keep an eye out for him. Maybe he'll be on the Ashland Legion squad if he keeps pitching like this. But this one hit in the air to deep left field, battling the sun, but making the catch is the left fielder. And he is able to reel that one in. Tough battle for Sam Athey out there. But they do get the third out. And we will head to the top half of the sixth inning with Hopkinton leading Holliston 6-2 on HCAN against midfield. Top half of the sixth inning as the Holliston Panthers will come up to the plate, trailing 6-2, down to their final six outs. Jake Obid, Zach Pessin, and Jack Larsh two up, the 4, 5, and 6 hitters. As Obid steps in to face Ryan Wolf. Wolf delivers a strike.
That's the second breaking pitch I've ever seen him throw. But he must have worked on it over the winter, because it wasn't there last year.
Wolf deals. There's another breaking pitch. This time hit up the third base side. Throw from across the diamond. No problem. 5-3 goes Obid. Dylan O'Leary getting the job done there, and Zach Pessin will come up to the plate. And the pitch, that is hit foul, just behind us, 0-1. Passing 0-2 so far. Wolf deals. Some nasty stuff there, 0-2.
Must be tough for the hitters to pick up with all his arms and legs moving.
That pitch had quite the drop on it. Just low, 1-2. Up the first base side, coming to a dive, but unable to wrap it up is LeBlanc, and the runner will be safe.
Good effort by Jake LeBlanc.
I'm scoring that a single. That's just a difficult ball to play. Awkward hit there for sure. Jack Larsh, the second baseman, will step in. 0-1, walked and scored a run in the fourth.
Coach Simo's called for no doubles.
There's a strike.
So Dylan O'Leary is moving closer to the third base line.
Line up and the pitch. There's another strike, 0-2. Louis Rossi in the on-deck circle for Holliston. Leg lift and the pitch. Outside, throw down the line. They almost got him. But he is just back safely. 1-2. Good throw by Reynolds.
Holliston runner is not venturing too far away from first base.
1-2 pitch. That one just outside, 2-2. Yeah, Wolf has quite a pickoff move.
That he does.
Checking at first. Nearly got him there. He slides back safe. Coming into this game, Wolf made one appearance on the mound prior, pitched 2 innings, gave up 3 hits and 2 runs. Runner leading off of first, the windup and the pitch. There's a swinging strike, and he got him. 2 away. Louis Rossi will step in.
Ryan Wolf is really pitching, using all of his pitches.
Yeah, a wide array of stuff. And it's getting to these Holliston hitters so far.
the first base side foul towards the Holliston bench.
Holliston needs runs. They can't afford to make the third out by getting picked off.
The wind's starting to pick up a bit here. It's always windy here at these Hopkinton fields. There's a strike. Set to deliver. That one down low, got by Reynolds, and the runner is going to hold up at first. He actually could have probably took off there and landed safely at second, but decided not to risk it.
I don't know whether Coach Simos had a play there. Jake LeBlanc was not holding on the runner, but was moving in behind the runner while Ryan still had his foot on the rubber.
Wind up in the pitch. Breaking pitch is popped up into the infield grass. Nearly a collision there, but what a job by Wolf pulling that one away from Dawson McMillan, who is running in for the third and final out. And we will head to the bottom half of the sixth. Hopkinton leading Holliston 6-2. Bottom of the sixth inning, Zach Sosicki coming up to the plate for the Hillers. 8-9-1 due up. Sosicki will step in. He is 0-1, did sacrifice in the first and drove in a run. Swinging strike there. He really took a hack at that one.
He wasn't cheated. He never gets cheated. Part of the Hopkins and Hillers senior backcourt next year.
One down low, 1-1. Dylan O'Leary in the on-deck circle.
Zach does like to go the other way.
Line up and the pitch. Up the middle it goes, and it's gloved by the shortstop. Throw to first. They got him. That was a nice play by Jake Bohr.
He hit that one right on the screws.
Yeah, got a good piece of it, but Bohr able to get to it just in time. Now Dylan O'Leary will step in. He was pinch hit for his last time up. Leary had a 2 RBI single in the first. Line up and the pitch, swinging strike. Set to deliver. That one in the dirt, 1-1.
Holliston playing him straight away.
You wonder what the outcome of this game would have been if Kip Stoppa got the start for Holliston. Could have been a totally different story. Pitching very well out there since coming in relief in the first for Ben Dooley, as this one will drop into right field for the base hit. And O'Leary is aboard with the one out single. Ben McKenzie will step in. Stoppa set to deal. That one just low, 1-0. Line up and the pitch. This is hit in the air to right field, and it is going to be caught by the center fielder who ranges over. And there's two away. Seymour calling Ringy off that one.
Dylan had to play that ball halfway.
Yeah, Larry back to the first base bag, and now Dawson McMillan will step in. 0-1, but he's walked twice and scored a run. Runner leading off of first. There's the bunt down the third baseline, foul.
One of your better bunters in the TVL, Dawson McMillan. He's never afraid to lay one down.
Runner leading off of first. Wind up and the pitch. Just outside, 1-1. Set to deal. Fouled away into the backstop, 1-2. Leg lift and the pitch inside. 2-2. The sign and deals just outside, full count.
Hopkinton bullpen is busy again.
Runner taking off from first as this one is hit in the air to right center, and ranging over is Seymour. He'll make the catch for the third and final out. And we will head to the top half of the seventh. Holliston down to their final three outs on HCAN. Top half of the seventh, Holliston down to their final three outs. 8-9-1 coming up to the plate. Jake Poor, Sam Athey, and Brad Seymour due up for the Panthers. And we have a new pitcher for the Hopkinton Hillers. Mitch Carpe in the game to close it out. Takes over for Ryan Wolf, who had a great outing coming into the game in relief. There's a strike.
It's nice to see Coach Simos is using his full complement of players as opposed to sticking with a rotation of just eight and having the kids ride the bench.
1-1 pitch now to Poor. One just outside, 2-1. Ryan Wolf went 2 1/3, gave up two hits, no runs, and had a strikeout.
It was nice to see Brian Gaughan warming up at the bullpen, one of the Hiller captains. Had been injured most of last year and injured for the first part of this year with a non-throwing shoulder injury. And now he's ready to go, it looks like.
3-1 pitch, and therefore a strike, grabs the inner corner, full count now. And this is hit into center field and caught. Ben McKenzie right there for the catch, one away. That'll bring up Sam Athey, the left fielder. 1-for-2 on the day, had a single in the third, flew out in the fourth. Up and the pitch just inside. Set the deal. There's a strike. 1-1 pitch. On the ground, right side. Picked up by the second baseman, throw to first, no problem. 4-3 goes Athey, two away. Back to the top of the order, Brad Seymour, the center fielder, stepping in. It's been a very good defensive effort for the Hillers today. Some great pitching as well. strike to Seymour. Tom Leone started the game. He went 3 2/3, gave up 5 hits, 2 runs, 2 walks, 2 strikeouts. Ryan Wolf came in relief, pitched 2 1/3 of scoreless baseball. That one upstairs. Pitch to Seymour, and it's fouled away, almost taking out Coach Simos there. Set to deliver. One just upstairs. 2-2. Two-two pitch, swinging strike, and that will do it. Wolf strikes out the final hitter, and the Hopkinton Hillers take down the Holliston Panthers 6-2. The Hillers scored all 6 of their runs in the first inning. They did it on 3 hits, and that is all the offense that they would need. The winning pitcher is Tom Leone, and the loss for Holliston goes to Ben Dooley. The Hopkinton Hillers improved to 2-2 on the season, while the Holliston Panthers fall to 1-5. For Bob Hamilton on camera, my broadcast partner Larry Sacklad, I'm Tom Nappy, and we thank you for watching Hopkinton Hillers baseball on HCAM. Enjoy the rest of your day, folks, and we'll talk to you soon.